This video is all about tire pressures and how you get them spot on. Well, the first question, of course, is how do you do it now? Most people look at the manufacturer's plaque on the door, set the pressures, and that's it. Ready to go. Hope for the best. Now, if you've got standard size wheels and tires, that can work. But what if you've got wider tires, stretched tires, low profile, lots of negative camber? And how about your driving? What if you drive on the interstate all day? What if you drive on a mountain road, downhill all day? These things are just not something the manufacturer can account for. So they can't tell you what the best tire pressure is for you. So we have to work it out. First of all, we need to talk about what correct pressure looks like in terms of what it does to the heat in the tires. So if we have a look at the diagram here, we'll see under-inflated tire. The pressure is on the outside edges, and the center doesn't have enough pressure to push it flat. Here is an over-inflated tire, and it's the opposite. The center has been pushed out, and the edges are not quite in as much contact with the road as they should be. And finally, the correct pressure is everything equally warm. The tire is sitting flat against the road, maximum contact, even spread of temperatures, and as a result, the tire will last longer and it won't overheat in one particular place quickly, causing a loss of traction. The trouble comes when we look at the next diagram. That's when we have cars that have negative camber, and that is just about every car you're going to drive now. And of course, if you're doing some modifications, you might want even more negative camber to improve cornering grip. So when we put negative camber on a car, suddenly it's very difficult to get an even spread of temperature because one side is pushing into the road a lot more than the outside of the tire. But the best, usually the best we can hope for is to have a bit warmer on the inside. They're not quite as warm on the outside, and in the center of the tire, we want the temperature to be right in the middle between those two, and that way we'll get a good, as even as possible wear, resulting in the most possible grip. That's the plan. That's what we're trying to achieve today. Now for the warnings. Using the method I'm going to show you today, you shouldn't need to go outside the manufacturer's recommended tire pressures. The only reason you might be pushed in that direction is if you have stretched tires. If you stretch too far, you push, depending on the tire, you either push the center up or you pull it down. Sometimes you have to put a lot of pressure in to get that tire to sit flat, or as flat as possible if you've got a lot of negative camber as well. The final thing is, this is for road cars with road tires. If you have a race car, you've got other considerations. You might need to get heat in your tires by the first corner at all cost. The rest of it doesn't really matter anywhere near as much. So, and on that note, let's get on with it and see what I'm actually doing here today. Okay, we're looking at the tire information chart in the driver's door. And as you can see, or maybe not, none of these tires or sizes match what I've got, so we'll go for the closest one, which is 2.2 bar and 2.6 bar. 2.2 bar is about 32 psi and 2.6 bar is about 38 psi, so we'll put that in the tires and we'll see what we get to start with. Okay, let's go for a drive and see what these pressures do to the heat in our tires. See if we can get a nice even spread of heat over the whole tire. So if you do all motorway driving, then do 10 minutes of driving on the motorway. If you do back roads, scratching around tight corners, then that's what you need to do before you test your tire warmth. Start from the outside, then the middle, and then the inside. Point the gun at nice block of rubber, not at the gaps between if you can avoid it. And with these guns, they're not very accurate if you hold them far away. So push it right up against the tire. Okay, we've got some numbers. Let's get those numbers up. Now the front tire is pretty close, but the back tire is way, way off. That'll need quite a bit of extra air to bring that center of the tire up to temperature. So we'll go off and get some additional air in. And you might be thinking at this point, where's the rest of the video? What tire pressure did you hone in on? Well, I'm not going to tell you. This video is about your car, your driving, your experience, your tires, your camber. So what I set my car to with my driving, with my load, is really not going to help you at all. Even if you have the same tires, the same car, the same power, the same load, you need to work this out for yourself. So it's up to you. If you haven't already got one, get yourself an infrared thermometer. Get measuring. You don't even have to know what the pressure is. You just have to know that, ooh, I need to add a bit or I need to take a bit away in order to get that center section to be right in the center of the two outside temperatures. It's the cheapest performance upgrade you're ever going to have. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you think your friends would like it, share it with them. If you want to see more videos on how to improve your car at a reasonable cost whenever possible, subscribe and hit that notification bell. I have more videos coming. Bye for now.